If the war in Iraq has a finish line, then Camp Virginia is it. In the last 6 weeks, as many as 350 vehicles a day have been rolling into this remote base in the Kuwaiti desert, delivering soldiers and equipment.
No water, no MREs.
No water, no MREs. No brass, no ammo.
Here, teams work day and night, guiding convoys through a series of stops. Each one like an assembly line in reverse, taking off, or as they say, downloading equipment accumulated over years of war.
And so what sort of stuff are they getting out at this particular point?
They're getting out, getting any POL, any kind of oil, fuel, batteries, anything that was not issued to them or that they bought, they download in here.
Pull it all out.
Everything is sorted and collected to be thrown out, recycled, or put back in service.
We brought you to this motor pool because really it's one of the few places where you can go to get a sense of just how much we're talking about, how many vehicles, how many trucks, how much stuff. And this is just the tip of the iceberg.
Camp Virginia has the capacity to house close to 7,000 troops and more than 5,000 vehicles.
Clear.
And even though officials say they're below those levels, they admit it's been challenging keeping up with what's coming out of Iraq.
It's very busy. And I will say that we're making use of every available cot we have, all the space that we have, but it's going really well.
All right, at ease, listen up. Hey, welcome to Camp Virginia.
There are signs of strain. The base has had to greatly increase housing and office space, and the dining hall now remains open 24 hours a day just to keep everyone fed. The goal is to move the soldiers from convoy to a flight back to the U.S. within 5 to 8 days, but officers admit it can sometimes take longer. And the next convoy into Camp Virginia is not expected until November 30th to allow the system time to catch up. Yet despite such problems, morale remains high. Because as every soldier who makes it here knows, the next stop is home. Martin Savage, CNN, Camp Virginia, Kuwait.